imagery is about beautiful, being beautiful. And I researched the word beauty in the Webster's Dictionary, and it defined beauty as the quality of being physically attractive. And I also looked up some synonyms. And those synonyms were attractiveness, beautifulness, gorgeousness, handsomeness. And I've noticed that all of these things describe the person's looks, the outside appearance. I also searched up a campaign done by Dove, and it was called Truth About Beauty. Did you know that 4% of women around the world consider themselves beautiful? Only 4%.
Wow.
Also, 11% of women are comfortable with using the adjective beautiful to describe themselves. 80% of women would rather use the word beautiful to describe another woman. We as women are more comfortable with using the word beautiful to describe someone else rather than ourselves. I see that today. Social media, magazines, pop culture. They've twisted God's version of beauty into something that has to be about our appearance. But what they forgot, that beauty is defined by God and God alone. When you hear the phrase, she is beautiful. She is beautiful. What's the first thing that pops into your head? Am I talking about her outward appearance? Her inward appearance? She is beautiful. But I do have a question. Who are you allowing to be your mirror? We look in a mirror every single day to see what we look on the outside, to make sure that we look appropriate for the world. Before I got up here, I checked myself out in the mirror. To make sure I looked appropriate to do this. But who are you allowing to be your mirror? Mirror, mirror, on the wall, who's the fairest of them all? Are you allowing society to be your mirror? Are you allowing man, women, a magazine, social media to define who you are in Christ? Who are you allowing to be your mirror? If a man or woman thinks I'm pretty, then I'm pretty. If a man or woman thinks I'm worth wanting, then I have worth. If a man or woman thinks I have value, then I have value. If a man or woman thinks I'm good enough, then I'm good enough. These are the thoughts that young ladies my age, even younger, are thinking today. Our world is so twisted. It's telling us we need to hold a certain image to be qualified, to be worthy, to have value. When you do allow man, society, or a magazine to become your mirror, you begin to see a twisted vision of yourself. You begin to believe every single word they tell you about yourself. Your body is a source of approval. Your body is a way to get the love you long for. Your body is a toy. Show a little skin. You're beautiful. Be sexy. You're beautiful. Have at it, baby girl. You're beautiful. You are only as good as you look to them. You let them measure your value, your worth, your beauty. You let the world tell you who you're supposed to be today. We as women wake up every morning making sure that we look beautiful. But what's going on in the inside? If I cut you open, would I be able to see all the hurt, all the blood stains, all the broken pieces that's left in your heart? Are you willing to show that to the world? Show me your beauty. I do have another question. Who do you reflect? Who's your mirror? Now I'm asking, who are you reflecting? Are you reflecting the things of this world? Are you reflecting Jesus? When God the Father looks at me, he doesn't see what I used to be. When God the Father looks at me, he sees Jesus.
Amen.
Who are you reflecting? Who does God see? The only way to discover who God is, we have to turn away from the mirror of this world. And we have to turn to his mirror, his unchanging mirror. In Malachi 3:6 it says, I, the Lord, do not change. In Numbers 23:19 it says, God is not human that he should lie, not a human being that he should change his mind. Does he speak, then not act? Does he promise and not fulfill? This world's opinion changes each and every day. And if you're trying to live by the world's opinion, I'm sorry, but you're going to crumble. A man's opinion can change. A man can shift. My God is stable.
Amen.
Even the best man can make mistakes. Even the best man can fall. Even the best man can promise, but not fulfill. Even the best man can accuse or disappoint. Even the best man can leave. Even the best man can choose another. Even the best man can tell you if you're beautiful or not. But God, he is our rock. He is our stronghold. He is our deliverer. He is our fortress, our high tower, our shelter.
Amen.
We look far and wide to fill a void that can never be replaced.
Amen.
This world did not create me.
Amen.
This world did not create this heart that is longing to be filled. God created this heart. God created me. So how dare I go out into the world to find my identity?
Amen. Amen.
Hebrews 13:5 says, God says, never will I leave you. Never will I forsake you. Remember when I told you even the best man can leave? I have a promise from God that tells me that he will not leave me.
Amen.
He will not forsake me.
Amen.
But yet,
thank you, Jesus.
We still find ourselves calling back to the world.
Amen.
When we know that our God will not leave. In the pages of the Word, you will start to discover a man who loves you despite the way you fall short. You will discover a man who accepts you just the way you are.
Amen.
The old hymn, come just as you are. Our God is not impressed by our outward appearance. He's not impressed by what I look like. That's not what he wants. Our God wants our heart. You see, we're taught in the Old Testament that our heart is our central being, our soul, who we are. That's what God wants. That's what he wants. A king will never leave you, will never forsake you. Our king will never leave us, will never forsake us. 1 Samuel 16:7 says, the Lord does not look at things man looks at. Man looks at the outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart. God looks upon the inner beauty, the beauty of one's heart. Proverbs 31:30 says, charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised.
Amen.
You see, faith in a loving and forgiving God will be the root in any and all manifestations of beauty. Physical beauty will fade over time. But true beauty is timeless.
Amen.
Psalms 139:14 says, I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. I know that full well. Do you know that? I read that verse and some of you ladies shook your head in agreement. But do you truly know that? You see, we're living in a world where it's an epidemic. That being beautiful on the outside is what gives you your worth and your value.
Yeah.
And if you're not beautiful, then you have no worth. Here in Psalms 139, David is saying, I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. My God doesn't make junk.
Amen.
I'm not junk.
Amen.
You are not junk.
Amen.
You are beautiful just the way you are. We're taught, if you're too pale, you need a tan. If you're too dark, you need bleaching cream to lighten your skin. We're taught that if you're too big, there's a problem. If you're too skinny, there's a problem. a certain amount of hair, it's a problem. If your butt isn't a size bigger, that's a problem. If your breasts aren't a size double D, that's a problem. You see how the world's opinion can change? I, the Lord, do not change. Ecclesiastes 3:11 says, "He has made everything beautiful." Everything. Not just the beautiful birds and the trees and the sun and the stars and the moon and the grass. Not just that. That includes you. He has made everything beautiful. And you need to know that because you are beautiful. Everything about you is beautiful, from the size of your hips to the curve of the smile on your face to the strand of your hair to the color of your skin. You are beautiful. And you are more than your body. You are more than your appearance. You are more than enough. You are loved. You are precious. You are holy. You are set apart. You are different. You are the daughter of a king. You are beautiful just the way you are. And you are a temple. 1 Corinthians 6:19 verses 19 through 20 says, "Don't you know your bodies are temple of the Holy Spirit who is in you, whom you received from God? You are not your own. You have bought with a price. Therefore, honor God with your body." Paul says you were bought with a price, a very high price. That price was when God sent his one and only son to die on the cross for you. That was the price that God paid for you. And you go out and you let the world define who you're supposed to be today. God already bought you. Don't sell yourself. Don't give yourself away for free. You are bought with such a high price. Don't you know that you yourselves are God's temple and that God's Spirit dwells in your midst? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy that person. For God's temple is sacred, and you together are the temple. This body is sacred. Your body is sacred. Your body is a temple. Your body is not a toy. Your body is not something to be given away to measure your value. That is not what God created you for. Your body is sacred. Our bodies are not things to be bought and sold or given away at will. Our bodies are not objects to be analyzed and criticized whenever someone looks at me. That is not what my body was meant for. My body is a temple. My body is sacred. My body is beautiful. I am beautiful.
Amen. Amen.
You are beautiful. I would like to read something to you guys. It's from a book called Beautiful Lies by Jennifer Strickland. It says, the Lord speaks. Magazines are made of words and images printed on paper, which burns in the fire. The only everlasting word on earth was, is, and always be the word of God. The magazines have had their time of year of power and influence. I have allowed that. Yet like the glory of man, they will fade and fall. Meanwhile, my word stands forever. I'm very specific when I craft a temple. The measurements, the height, the adornments. I've crafted you the same way. Because your body is my temple. The exactness, the artistry, the creativity. They are all reflections of my love for you. But what if you came into my temple? With all its golden adornments, its burning candles and incense, the symphony of harps, drums, bass, horns, and piano. And inside, you saw me selling wares at too high a price, ripping people off. What if you were drawn into the intricate carvings of angels on the marble facade, but on a closer look, found drugs, wickedness, prostitution? What if I allowed hatred, bloody violence, and children to be whipped inside my house? Where would you go then for peace and tranquility? So it is with this generation of women. You don't know what a temple is. You don't know about my holy place. You don't know how it tears my heart to see my daughters sell themselves, or even worse, give themselves away for free. It makes me cry. I'm calling you back. I'm calling you back, my daughter. My temple, cleansed of her bloodstains, made pure as snow. Through the torn curtain, enter my chamber. Come away with me. And learn how much you're worth, how you are sacred. Oh, how I love the temple. You are a temple.
Amen.
And oh, how God loves his temple. See, there is a point in my life where I allowed the world to determine who I was supposed to be. I allowed the world to tell me that I was too dark. I allowed the world to tell me that my lips were too big. I allowed the world to tell me that the size of my body was not good enough. I allowed the world to measure my value, to measure my beauty. I let the world do that to me. And I was empty. I was unsatisfied with myself. I asked God, why would you make me like this? But then God spoke to me in ways that I never thought I could ever be spoken to. You see, I found a book. It's called the Bible. And in there he wrote a beautiful love letter to me. He told me that I was beautiful, that I was loved, that I was precious. He told me that I was sacred. He told me I was a daughter of a king.
Amen.
My God made me feel complete. He made me feel whole. You see, when you open God's word, that's what you find. I have fallen in love with a man that sees Jesus in me. I have fallen in love with a man that doesn't see who I used to be. I have fallen in love with a man who loves me just the way I am. I have fallen in love with a man who gives me joy that I could never imagine. I have fallen in love with a man who redefined what love is supposed to be. I've fallen in love with a man who told me I was beautiful. Because only God and God alone defines beauty. I just want you guys to know that you guys are beautiful. Just the way you are. But I can't keep telling you that. You need to start to believe it for yourself. You need to open God's word and discover a man who loves you just the way you are. He calls you to come just as you are. Come just as you are. My God is beautiful. And everything he's created is beautiful. Every single woman in here is beautiful. Like I said, to the size of your hips, to the smile on your face, to the color of your skin, to the size of your eyes, to the fullness of your hair. You are beautiful. To each little wrinkle on your body, to every little stretch mark on your body, you are beautiful. Please, don't let this world define who you're supposed to be. Don't let this world tell you how you're supposed to be. Don't let this world tell you what you're worth. Don't let this world tell you whether you're beautiful or not. Because I'm standing right here and I'm telling you that you are beautiful. And once you open up God's word, you will find out that you are beautiful. I would like all of us to close our eyes as I read this. It's called The Father Speaks. My daughter, how I long to gather you in my arms. I know that all too well the ways man have left you, lied to you, disappointed you, and abandoned you to struggle. For some of you, man has been a hammer smashing the precious stones I laid so carefully in the floor of your heart. The weight of its burden can wrap itself around you like a heavy chain. It can sink you toward the bottom if you let it. It would have been better for those who hurt you to have been drowned in the heart of the sea. I can handle those who hurt you. Just give them to me. But now I'm saying to you, daughter, live. Let me lift you up and carry you to the surface. Let me have your heart, for only I can repair it. Let me cover you with the corner of my velvet robe. Let me be your blanket. Let me spread you with my hand over you and shade you from this storm, this rain, this lightning that is splintering your sky and breaking the earth beneath your feet. Daughter, I am your high power. I have so much for you. Come to me, my storm-tossed daughter. Come to me. There is healing beneath my wings. There is healing beneath my wings. Come just as you are. There is healing beneath our Heavenly Father's wings. There is peace beneath his wings. There is joy beneath his wings. Beneath his wings, you find your worth. You find your identity. You find your beauty. Beneath his wings, you find that you are God's daughter. You find that you are his precious creation. You find that you are his beautiful temple. You find that you are his shining light. You are the daughter of a king, of a great king, of a wonderful king. And he tells you that you are beautiful because everything he has made is beautiful. Everything. I don't want to leave this speech just like this. Because there seems to be a lot of hearts that are hurting. If any of you want prayer, I am here. I know dinner starts soon. But I will be here. If you want me to pray with you, I am here. Just remember, the Lord says, never will I leave you, never will I forsake you. Thank you.